couple more minutes just because we have people still coming in, so we're going to hold for a couple more minutes. If we could have people scoot in towards the middle, I love that we have people standing in the back, but let's make... Good evening, and welcome to the 2023 West Jesmond Middle School Spring Choir Concert. My name is Katie Bayshore, and I am the choir and theater director here at West Jesmond Middle School. Before we get started, I just wanted to say a couple thank yous. I wanted to say thank you to West Jesmond High School, as always, for hosting these wonderfully talented but a little crazy middle schoolers for our concerts. We are oh so grateful to get to perform on a real stage. What a blessing it is. I also would like to say thank you to Rena Tanaka, our accompanist this evening. I would now like to introduce Hadley McMillan, who is our eighth grade vice president. I was like, which role are you? Vice president.
Hi, my name is Hadley McMillan, and I'm an eighth grader here at West Middle, and I'm also the vice president of the West Jesmond Middle School Choir. And I would just like to say thank you all so much for coming, and I can't wait for you all to see all the hard work that we've been putting in for the past few months. And without further ado, the West Jesmond Middle School Choirs.
They have grown so much this school year, and I am so incredibly proud of them. So our spring concert is what we call a cabaret. So it's filled with songs from movies and musicals and pop songs and all of the above. So it's their favorite concert and definitely one of mine as well. But as a part of our cabaret, I always like to invite some eighth graders and some seventh graders as well to sing solos, trios, and duets. So our first solo of the evening is eighth grader Weston Cross singing Corner of the Sky from Pippin.
Everything has its season, everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. So why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Every man has his daydreams, every man has his goal. People like the way dreams have a sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning, nightingales have their song. And don't you see, I want my life to be something more than long. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. So many men seem destined to settle for something small, but I won't rest until I know I'll have it all. So don't ask where I'm going, just listen when I'm gone. And far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky.
Equality and equal rights with men.
you fear?
So cast off the shackles of yesterday, shoulder to shoulder into the fray. Our daughters, daughters will adore us, and they'll sing in grateful chorus. Well done, well done, well done, sister suffrage.
Lillian Keenan. Lillian played Winifred in our production back in March of Mary Poppins. Mary Poppins Junior, and the junior productions tend to cut songs so that we can get it down to an hour long length, and Winifred's song was one of those, and I said, well, you're gonna sing it, I'm gonna make sure of it. So of course we had to have Mary Poppins represented. Coming on stage now is seventh grade choir singing All Is Found from Frozen 2. Each year, all arts teachers in Jesmyn County are asked to choose art stars. Now, I am blessed that I get to teach both choir and drama, so I get to choose choir, a choir art star, and a theater drama art star as well. So this next duet is sung by our two art stars. Kylie Woody is our choir art star. And Jocelyn Seward is our theater art star. I am very proud of both of them, and both of them represent our program, our school, and our county beautifully. So without further ado, this is Impossible.
You could change it all. You can make it all happen.
No, but you can change it all. You can make it all happen.
Never. I couldn't.
You're right. It's all so
impossible.
Impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. Impossible for a plain country pumpkin and a prince to join in marriage. Never before ride horses, such funeral and fiddly D of corsets. Impossible, impossible. For the world is full of zanies and fools who don't believe in sensible rules and won't believe what sensible people say. And because these haven't idioms keep building up impossible hopes, impossible things are happening.
This school year, West Jasmine Middle School was able to finally, for the first time since before COVID, to have what we call our cohorts. So cohort choir. To have what we call cohorts. And those are clubs that meet within school hours. And this year, I decided to have a choir cohort where it was students from all three grades, because outside of our beginning numbers and final numbers, students from all three grades don't usually get the opportunity to sing together. So I thought it would be great for the eighth graders to be great examples for our seventh and sixth graders, and for our sixth and seventh graders to get to experience singing with older students as well. So we have met probably a total of six times. And I am extremely proud of this group. They are so wonderful. So without further ado, this is 9 to 5.
Stumble to the kitchen, pour myself a cup of ambition, yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Jump in the shower and blood starts pumping, now
folks like me on job from 9 to 5.
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving, they just use your mind. And they never give you credit, it's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5, for service and devotion, you would think that I
your friends waiting for the day your ship will come in, but the tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna roll your way.
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving, they just use your mind. And they never give you credit, it's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5, the service and devotion, you would think that
our next trio are 8th grade students who are bringing a little New York jazz to this cabaret. They will be singing Easy Street from Annie.
I remember the way your sainted mother would sit and croon us her lullaby.
She'd say, kids, there's a place that's like no other. You gotta get there before you die.
You don't get there by playing from the rule book. You stack the aces, you load the dice. Mother dear, oh, we know you're down there listening. How can we follow your sweet advice to Easy Streets, Easy Streets? $4.
The little brat. It ain't fair, this here life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fast.
Maybe she holds the key, that little lady,
to getting more bucks
instead of less. Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Give you our guess. Yes. Easy Street. Amy is the key. Yes, sorry, yes, sorry, yes, sorry.
Up next, sorry, they make me giggle every time. Up next, we have our 7th and 8th grade choirs combined. Come on, 7th and 8th grade. The spring concert, the cabaret, I always let it be a student choice concert. So that means they get to choose, of course, with guidance from me. But they get to choose what pieces we sing, and A Million Dreams from The Greatest Showman was a resounding choice. But I said, you know, I can't just have one choir sing it. Why not have two? So without further ado, this is 7th and 8th grade choir singing A Million Dreams from The Greatest Showman.
My eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me that I call my own.
Through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home.
World that we need. gonna make.
We'll be singing Some Things Are Meant to Be from Little Women, the musical.
Pretend we're riding on a kite.
While eighth grade choir is coming on the stage, I would like to introduce two other people that were a part of our eighth grade leadership team this year that the eighth grade students voted on and really thought that they represented our program the way that it should be. The first that you saw tonight being Hadley McMillan, our vice president, and now I will introduce Angel Hernandez Sanchez, who is our secretary.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming to tonight's concert. As Ms. Bayshore has introduced me as Angel, eighth grade choir secretary, I just want to say thank you for everyone for coming for tonight's concert. It really means a lot to us. I know this might be our eighth graders' last concert for this year at West Jessamine Middle School, but that doesn't mean we'll stop making memories and stop singing. A very special thank you to Ms. Bayshore for helping us learn these songs for the past months, for making them memorable and amazing, learning these pieces of music. Thank you, Ms. Bayshore, for helping us grow into the beautiful flowers we are tonight. We will never forget or the people we have gone to meet because of you. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. As you guys, hopefully you know, I'm President Madison Bishop, and I have a little lengthy speech, so get your popcorn ready. Mom, this is about you. Where are you? Hi, Mom. Okay. Mom, I really don't say this enough, but thank you. Thank you for being my rock, my best friend, my number one supporter, and always being there when I need someone to support me. I'm so proud to be your child. You're the reason I know risks pay off and to always go for my dreams no matter what. I can't imagine where I would be without you as a role model. Thank you for teaching me to always be me. I wonder how you could always be so selfless. You woke up every day at 6 in the morning to help us. You never complained about the fuss I would make at the breakfast table. I was naive back then to understand your sacrifices. Thank you for your relentless efforts in making us eat healthy and keeping our family together. In this ever-changing world, your love is one of the only constants. I've always idolized you. When I was a little girl, I wanted to dress like you, talk like you, and walk like you. Did you know, whenever my friends would say, your mom is so beautiful, or you have such an awesome mom, I would feel really proud. I'm sorry for yelling at you at times. You tolerated my tantrums, door slams, and silent treatments. Even though I was not the perfect child, you were always the perfect mom to me. I used to think heroes are extraordinary people who could shoot lasers and scale buildings, but then I realized that a mother in a suit is a superhero in a child's life, or at least mine. Life is never smooth sailing. I've had my difficult days, but do you know what made me go on in spite of all the hardships? It's you, Mom. You always believed in me and gave me that strength to go back and try harder. That's something nobody but you can do. We've had our days, we've had our moments, we've cried, we've laughed, but most importantly, we've made memories that no one could ever replace. You, Mom, are the reason I can wake up every morning and smile. You never fail from your totally funny jokes or your Facebook memes that only your laugh will make funny. And what I'm trying to say is you can never fail to make me laugh, even some of my darkest days. Thank you for pushing me to work hard as possible and always give 110%. You came to my softball games, basketball games, track meets, bowling matches, and most importantly, this concert when nobody else did. You stayed up with me at night when no one else did, and you listened to me when nobody else did. I love you. As much as I love you, I have to say a few words to our eighth graders who have worked so hard over the past 3 years to get to this point. All the assignments, long classes, rough days, you can say you did it. You do have to do this for 4 more years, maybe even more. 3 years ago today, I would never have thought for even a second I'd be standing here giving this speech. It feels like middle school has passed quicker than the 4-minute passing period they gave us. Now, I'm not going to say this was an easy journey, because it certainly wasn't. I've made friends, lost friends, and maybe even failed 6th grade English. I love you, Ms. B. But most importantly, I learned to not give up and continue to try. A lot has changed, and a lot will continue to change, but I'm so incredibly excited to see what the future holds for me and all my fellow peers. There's a universal truth, whether we have to face, whether we want to or not. Everything eventually ends. As much as I've looked forward to this day and getting out of middle school, I've always disliked endings. Last day of summer, the final chapter of a book, parting ways with a close friend. But endings are inevitable. Leaves fall, you close the book, you say goodbye. Today is one of those days for us. Today we say goodbye to everything that was familiar, everything that was comfortable. We're moving on, but just because we're leaving and we're moving on to something more, there's some people who will always be a part of us, who will be with us no matter what. They're our solid ground, our North Star, and the small, clear voices in our heart. Thank you, Ms. Bayshore.
Thank you. When we were choosing eighth grade songs, I told them, I said, you know, if we sing this, I'm not going to cry. And they said, yes, you will. Yes, you will. And that's okay. I'm very proud of this group. They have grown exponentially since my first day with them, August of 2021. It feels like a lifetime ago. Without further ado, eighth grade choir presents Remember Me from Coco. Thank you all so much for coming tonight. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your evening. Thank you.